You want to try one in the, in your mouth?
Oh, did it.
This evening's officials are Mr. Don Skinner and Mr. Marshall Ball.
All right, Jaren, what do you think about this game about to go on?
It's going to be a good game, I think, and it's going to be a big battle down low with two guys going head-to-head that are both the same height, Billy Brooks and Jared Fish, both standing at 6 foot 7 inches.
Yeah, it should be interesting. You got some good competition out there.
Mm-hmm.
Salamanca has recently lost to Silver Creek, though, the first time they played them.
Yes, and I also understand that Salamanca had a bunch of good players that will be key to this game that weren't in the game last game.
Should be a good game, though. Let's see how this goes. Tip ball, and it's up. And Silver Creek. Warriors, good stance on defense.
Yeah, it looks like they're playing a zone defense.
Looks like they're almost playing a box and one, it looks like. Tad Beatty on the number three, their captain, I understand. Matt Crandall with the rebound. Seems like the Warriors are trying to push up the court. Cabady up and misses.
Oh, good defense by Tyler Siperic. And he looks to push the ball and loses it. Ball goes to Silver Creek.
All right, we got Marky Moore in the stands. Not yet. All right, Silver Creek passing around the ball, trying to penetrate. And a nice pass.
Good pass.
To number 45, Brennan White. Warriors pushing up the court. Okay, Beatty up with the three, and it misses.
Good rebound by Jared.
And King Kettle. Joseph Howe. All right, and Marky Moore.
Never mind. Basket's good from Kane Kettle.
Is a senior and the only captain, so this team must have faith in him, make his foul shots, and he does, makes both.
Warriors down four early in the game.
They're just driving.
Foul by number 45, Brennan White.
Fish takes the ball out.
Oh, good. Another foul.
A number three. I feel like if they get Kane Kettle out of the game early, they'll have a decent chance. You know, I feel like he's a key player.
Kane Kettle and Billy Brooks are their two main scorers.
Haven't seen much from Billy yet, but I'm sure he has. He knows what he's doing.
Good shot from Andy Crandall. Nice three-pointer. Andy Crandall gets hot fast, so they better get on him if they don't want him to score. Good steal.
Oh, lob pass. Not very good choice.
Gets his own rebound.
Andy up with the...
Nah.
Silver Creek pushing up the court. Pass number three. I feel like he's a go-to guy. Tad Beatty fouls him. I don't really know if that's a really good choice to make so early in the game.
Yep.
But it happens.
Mm-hmm. Only his first foul, but it'll be all right.
So the boys are actually on a win streak. They just had a big win over Allegheny and just recently Portville, and hopefully they'll come out with the W with this game.
We can only hope. And Kane Kettle finally misses at the free throw line.
You know,
makes his second, and he gets his third one since he shot a three and was fouled.
I feel like in this game, you have to make your free throw shots because that will make a difference in the game.
Mm-hmm. Always makes a difference.
Tyler Sparick bringing it up. He's the main point guard. We'll be seeing a lot of him tonight. He has really good ball handling skills. The Warriors passing it around.
Good fake by Jared to get to the basket and a nice pass.
And we got over the back on number 14, Connor Gates. That was a good call on the refs. Mm-hmm.
Good pass by Fish. And
he fouled Tyler Sparick.
Ty will be passing the ball in. Looks for Tad in the corner. Nice three-pointer from Tad Beatty.
Tad Beatty is known for his threes. You know, he can shoot anywhere around the perimeter, so they can't leave him open if they don't want him to shoot. Mm-hmm. Billy Brooks posting up and dumps it down.
Good defense by the Warriors there.
Coach K's yelling out some plays for the Warriors.
Ooh, not a good decision by Andy. Gets
Warriors.
It stolen.
Oh. Number 14 makes it. Connor Gates.
Oh.
I feel like the Warriors need better passes if they want a good outcome of this game.
Mm-hmm. They need to start holding on to the ball. A lot of turnovers early, which isn't good.
They just need to relax a little bit. I feel like they come to this game a little nervous, which they should be, and that's always good, but they should have a little bit of confidence.
Yeah. Slow it down and be patient with the offense. Right. Let it open up.
Playing good defense. Silver Creek passing it around. Excellent defense for the Warriors. Oh. Number 45 with the rebound. And he's up at the three.
Good
Jared
rebound
Fish.
By Jared Fish.
Pushing up the court. That was a questionable travel by Jared Fish.
Nice offensive rebound. Oh, but can't finish.
It was in and out.
That would have tied this game up as we're... About four minutes left in the game, and they're down two.
Into the first quarter.
First quarter. Thanks for correcting me. Nice basket by Brennan White.
Number 45. I feel like we're going to be seeing a lot of him tonight also. He seems like a key player to this game for Silver Creek. Warriors passing it around. Trying to find an opening, and Everybody's cutting.
Oh.
Jared Fish gets a rebound and dumps it right back in.
Nice rebound. Nice heads-up play by Jared.
Oh, passing around for Silver Creek. And they're up with the three.
Oh.
Jared Fish with another rebound.
Oh.
Warriors passing around and passes it out. Damian Taylor in. You know what? Actually, everybody calls him the X Factor. He's been in the paper before, and that's what they call him, and that means he's like the go-to guy, and he has a special quality, and he often causes an unexpected change in events. So hopefully the Warriors can turn things up a little bit and make some points here.
Hopefully get the lead, as they're down 10-8.
The Warriors are playing a box in one on number three, Kane Kettle. He must be a key player. And Billy Brooks.
Strong, very strong down low.
Is that his first point for the night?
That is his first point for the night.
Oh, passing around.
Good pass.
Crandall up, and he looked like he pushed it up a little too hard. He's a little nervous. And Kane Kettle with two more points added on the boards.
Silver Creek's looking very good on the fast break tonight.
Yeah, they're very fast, and they're very intense. So hopefully if we can slow that down, make some better passes, things will be a little bit different.
Yeah, they're turning the ball over just a little too much.
Damian Taylor tries to go up for a big block, but doesn't seem to get it. Damian Taylor bringing up the ball. And we can't have lazy passes like that because then everybody gets a little crazy running around.
Turnovers are killing the Warriors tonight. Just need to slow it up and be calm with the ball.
The current score is 16-8, Silver Creek, and the time on the clock is 1 minute and 51 seconds in the first quarter.
Passes it into Damian Taylor, and he looks like he's going to go drive.
Good take by Damian Taylor.
Damian Taylor's a very excellent player. I think he's one of the best players Salamanca's ever seen. Number 14. Connor Gates adds three onto the boards. Warriors passing around, pass out to Ted Beatty, and he misses the three. Silver Creek always have a lot of fast breaks.
Oh, good defense by Damian. And way to save it, too.
Jared Fish driving.
Good. Oh, can't finish. Jared just cannot finish tonight.
You know, and that's one of Mr. K's keys. Actually, he said that they need to finish shots and play with a little edge and determination. So that's good advice from Mr. K. He also said that they need to stop Billy Brooks from getting touches inside and box out and look to push it in transition and shot fake and to look to attack. So if the Warriors follow what their coach says, he believes that they could come out with a win.
And stopping Billy Brooks, they're doing a pretty good job. He hasn't scored too much down low.
The Warriors are giving them easy baskets, which can be fixed very fast. Warriors passing it around. Damian up with a deep three, and it's in. You can't leave him open anywhere on the court, even if it's a deep three, half court, at the foul line. He'll make it anywhere.
He is a very excellent player. Very fun to watch.
Yeah, you never know what he's going to do. He always does his little tricks, and he can dunk, and he's really exciting. Billy Brooks trying to get position. And Kane Kettle gets it, and they call a travel.
Good defense by the Warriors there.
The crowd thinks that was a good call, and hopefully this will help out the Warriors a little. Jared Fish brings in a sub for Matt Crandall. We would also like to thank our sponsors, Major Mountain Alpacas, and their store is called So Soft Gift Shop. Just a reminder, you know, head down there and get some alpaca socks for running, hiking, and also skiing. So go check that out in Little Valley. Warriors passing it around.
Oh.
And There's a little bit of confusion on the court. Andy Crandall was expecting a foul on the three and didn't get it.
But there's actually a foul on Jared Fish down low, pushing the back.
Number 44 passes in. And that's the end of the first quarter.
Marking.
The score is 13 Warriors, 21 Knights.
So, Ariel, what do we have for points for the Warriors?
So far, Jared Fish has 3 points, and Andy, Matt, and Damian each have one.
So let's talk about Joe Hinman. He actually had a hip injury recently, and he was out for a little while. So they call it the return that he's back in. He's ready to go. It doesn't even seem like he's been out. You know, he comes back, he works hard, and everything like that. All right, and we're taking this to In the Stands with Marky Moore.
I'm here with the principal of Salamanca High School, Mrs. Anderson. Mrs. Anderson, how do you think the game's going so far?
I think that it's going great. I see we're a little behind, but I fully expect our boys to pick it up and to end up with a win.
How do you think the season has gone so far?
I'm very pleased with them. They've been working hard with Coach K. They've all been pulling together. I'm real excited about this year's team.
Are there any players that stick out to you in particular?
I'm sorry?
Are there any players that stick out to you in particular?
It would be unfair as the principal to pick any particular student, but I think they're all doing a fine job, and I just really appreciate how they work together. It's real nice to see that.
Okay, thank you. Back to you, anchors.
Thank you, Marky. The Warriors just passed it in, and they're just passing around. I haven't missed anything. Jared Fish driving, and they knock it out of his hands. I feel like Silver Creek knows that they need to help out, give some help defense to Jared Fish, because they know how he can score. Number 45, Brennan White, with 2 points on the board. We need to stop him. That was an easy basket underneath, so that can easily be stopped. Damian Taylor with a deep three again. Oh, and just misses.
Good rebound by Tad.
Jared Fish posting up, and he's left. Oh,
and off. Jared does not look like himself tonight.
He looks like he's getting a little frustrated. He needs to have a little confidence and shake it off, and good things will come if you work hard.
Mm-hmm.
Silver Creek passing it around. Warriors with some good defense. Passes it to Kane Kettle.
And that's off.
And number 44 comes in out of nowhere through three of the Warriors, and he's still. I don't really know what happened there. Looks like everyone got tangled up, Billy Brooks and Damian Taylor, but
they'll call a foul on Damian. Billy Brooks will be at the line.
They actually know each other on a personal level, though, so they just shook it off and wasn't even mad about it.
Mm-hmm.
You know, things happen like that. And they're passing it in. Silver Creek.
Oh, good tip by Jared. Good defense.
Tosh Farrick trying to drive. And
good
he
take.
Makes it. I feel like the Warriors need to drive a little bit more and put some pressure on them.
Need to cause some fouls.
Yeah.
Get Billy in foul trouble. I think that's the key.
So 45 again, open underneath, but misses. Damian Taylor bringing it up. Andy Crandall driving,
oh.
And Billy Brooks stuffs it, which is a questionable foul, and Silver Creek's crowd does not seem too happy about that.
Good take, though, by Andy to get to the basket.
That's what you got to do. I mean, if you want to foul, you got to drive and hope for the best. So what do you think about Winter Weekend, Jaron, coming up?
It's going to be pretty exciting. Last one as a senior. So it'll be fun.
Are you going to go show off your dance moves?
Oh, you know it. I'll be there right on the dance floor.
Billy Brooks with a big rebound. Silver Creek bringing it up. Passing it around. They have a lot of good starters, actually. I feel like they can rely on each other for
different things. Oh, and Joe Hinman and Matt Crandall are ready to get subbed in. So
good rebound by Tyler Sipek.
Breakaway by Tad Beatty.
Oh.
And he tries to dump it off to Andy Crandall, but it goes out. And they look a little frustrated about that, but they just need to shake it off and keep playing.
I think Tad should have just went up with that one.
Yeah. He would have just had better luck drawing the foul than trying to pass it out.
Mm-hmm.
All right, Silver Creek bringing it up. Passing it around and up with the three, and no good. Matt Crandall with the rebound, and Andy bringing it up, pushing up the court.
Nice. Good bucket by Jared Fish.
See, if he just relaxes and does his post moves like he knows how to, good things will come. So we're going to be passing it around. Damian good. Taylor with the steal.
Good defense. Good take by Damian Taylor. Good defense. He's a good offense.
And a lob pass to Kane Kettle, and he's up and makes it.
Nice floater by Kane. Warriors looking to push.
Damian Taylor up the three, and he makes it. And he's showing off his little three on his hands. You know, just gives you the chills after that happens. The crowd goes wild and
feel good about yourself.
Yeah.
That's Damian's fourth point for the night.
And many more to come. I feel like he's just starting to get on a roll, so he almost just had another steal. The ref with the call. It must have been someone on the Warriors. Joe Hinman, his first foul. Billy Brooks posting up and kicks it right back out. 14 up with the three, Connor Gates.
That was a good look from Billy Brooks to kick it out.
Yeah, it was a good choice.
Double team.
Damian driving and up. Oh, and he just misses. Silver Creek bringing it up. And passing to Billy Brooks.
No good. Rebound by Joe Hinman.
Joe Hinman looking really good out there. Can't even tell his hip was ever injured. You know, he can keep up with the guys. He's not lagging, and he's working really hard out there.
And that was a foul by Kane Kettle. His third, actually.
Damian Taylor bringing the ball up. Tyler Sipek getting ready to bring someone a sub. Jared Fish driving in, and
no
just
good.
Misses.
Oh, good steal by Andy, but cannot save it from going out of bounds.
Matt Crandall tries to help his brother out. You know, that's really nice, too. He's playing a senior year with his brother, who is a junior, so that must be exciting for them.
Mm-hmm. Good steal by Matt. Defense by the Warriors.
Jared Fish going up for this post move and makes it. I feel like they need to dump it into him a little bit more, and he knows exactly what to do. He knows exactly what he wants, and
that's his comfort zone right down there.
Right. Damian Taylor with a huge rebound. Joe Hinman passed it to Jared Fish. And Kane Kettle with another foul.
That's his fourth foul out there.
Only in the second quarter. Oh, looks like his third.
Now it's
fourth. A little. The crowd was a little questionable about that. So that's exactly what the Warriors wanted to do. So that's one of their goals they've actually met tonight. They get him out of the game. Since he was a big key, they can have a better chance.
One more foul and he's out, so coach better sit him down for a while.
Jared Fish up with his first foul shot and makes it. No, I see Mr. Weishen over there on the boys' bench, and he's actually the girls' basketball coach, which the girls are 8-1, so they have a good record. You know, the top scorers are Keely Wattles-Kasenis, both guards, and Frankie Wolf, tips it out. No, Frankie Wolf actually used to go here years and years ago. He used to go to this school, so we'll see tonight if he made the right choice in moving schools or not.
I feel like the second half of this game is going to get more intense.
Yeah, the Silver Creek's feeling a little pressured and since Kane's out, so.
Foul on number 44, Sherman Williams. And now Damian Taylor's at the line.
The current score is 28-25, Silver Creek, with 2 minutes and 28 seconds left in the second quarter.
It's a very close game, so hopefully Damian makes his foul shots, and I'm pretty confident he will. And the first one is made. So what's your guys' favorite day out of Spirit Week, by the way? I forgot to ask.
Class color day is
obviously class color day.
That is.
You know, we waited so long to wear black our senior year and win all of the events in the assemblies. So this year's our year, and
it is the best feeling.
It is.
Finally got here.
We should be very proud of all the accomplishments we've made, and graduating is a big accomplishment, whether people think it is or not. The cheerleaders over there with good encouragement to their players. They actually do a good job in the assembly too. They have the spirit stick and getting everybody pumped up.
Two behind you.
And they also have three seniors too. Silver Creek passing it around. Still passing it around. And they're doing a pass and cut. And there's 3 seconds left on the shot clock. And the shot goes up. And Matt Crandall rebounds it.
Way to be strong down low by Matt.
Yep.
There you go.
Damian Taylor. Tosh Barrett goes up, and he could have went up with the shot. And Matt Crandall with another steal. He seems to be really hot with steals tonight. Nice. Matt Crandall shot faked and Billy Brooks fell for it and went right up. So Matt draws the foul, which is exactly what they need. If they want a better chance of winning, they need to get Billy Brooks out of there. Which Billy Brooks and his sister, actually Jordan Brooks, both play for the Silver Creek Knights. And they just had an article in the paper and they were just called the Twin Towers. Even though they are not twins, they play the game alike. So that's very exciting for them. They're doing really good with their basketball.
Good job at the free throw line by Matt.
Silver Creek bringing the ball up. And pass to Billy Brooks. And Billy Brooks goes up strong and makes it. Damian with the deep three. And he just misses it. And Silver Creek passing it out with a little bit of confusion, but still makes it. By number 14, Connor Gates. Tosh back with some good ball handling. Passes to Damian. Warriors passing or opening or the cutter.
The Warriors need to start passing the ball a little bit better. They want to put the ball in the bucket.
Yeah, they can't have these easy lobs because Silver Creek has a really tall team, so.
Nice shot by Damian Taylor. He is lighting it up this half.
There's only 13 more seconds left in the second quarter.
Oh, good defense by the Warriors.
The Warriors actually needed this, too. Tab 80 up and makes it. The score is now tied with 3 seconds left.
Good half. That was a very good half.
The score is tied at the second quarter.
So we'll see what it's like when for the third quarter.
Tonight's game is sponsored by Major Mountain Alpacas.
All right, and the cheerleaders are doing their routine. They look really good out there with their new silver uniforms. And we also have Marky Moore.
Try one in your mouth.
The score is tied 32-32 going into the halftime. The Warriors are putting up a good fight and hopefully will continue it. If they follow with their goals, then they will come out with a good win.
That was a very good first half, and about to kick off a second half, and I hope it's just like that, but I hope Warriors pull it off.
Come out with the W, yeah. I know the Warriors work really hard, and so does Silver Creek, but obviously hopefully the Warriors win and continue their record as 8-3. Since Silver Creek won the first game, you know, they have to come back and they have to win the second game. Silver Creek passing around. Fast passes, kicks right back out to 14, and he drives and kicks out. Silver Creek's known for, like, driving and kicking out, and they have shooters anywhere.
Nice shot by number 45, Brendan White.
The Silver Creek head coach is also Rob Genko. Warriors passing it around. Looking for an opening, looking for the cutter, looking to drive. I see the first thing the Warriors always do is put the ball down and see what they can do. They don't just take it and dribble. They see if they can fake, if they can go around, you know.
Good bucket by Jared Fish.
They always keep their options open. Silver Creek bringing it up. And Andy Crandall with the rebound, but he gets fouled, and that looked like it hurt.
Second foul on number 44, Sherman Williams.
Andy's holding his back, and hopefully he's all right because he's a key player to this game, and they need him. Warriors passing around. Jared Fish posting up. And he goes. And he just misses. If he just keeps trying, he'll get it.
Good block by Andy. Almost saved it, but not.
It's always nice to see players get on the ground for a loose ball. It shows that they're dedicated, and they obviously want the ball more than the other team.
Timeout by the Black Knight.
So, Jaren, how about that wrestling tournament this weekend? Tell us a little bit about that.
Yeah, there's a wrestling tournament at our school this weekend, and it starts on Friday about 5 o'clock, and then Saturday it'll go all day. It'll probably start at like 9 o'clock and end around 6, 5 o'clock, finals will start, and that's when you want to come down and see some good wrestling.
Who's some key players? All right, here we go to Marquee.
I'm here with captain of the cheer squad and senior Rachel Delansky. How do you think that the cheerleading squad is doing this year so far?
Personally, I think the cheer squad is doing pretty fantastic. We've made it through a few of our goals, and apparently it's the best this team's ever been since 14 years.
And I know that your last winter weekend is coming up soon. How do you feel about that?
It's a bittersweet moment. It's kind of being glad to be gone, but I'm going to miss everybody, and it's going to be a fun dance.
What are your plans after high school?
I'm planning on attending Juilliard, but I'm going to go to St. Bonnet's for a year or two.
Awesome. Thank you, Rachel. Back to you, anchors.
Thank you, Marky. Silver Creek is passing it around.
Good basket by Brennan White.
So, Jaren, back to the wrestling. I hear that Brad Cunningham is a key wrestler.
Yes, he is actually ranked number one in the section this year. His record's about 28-2.
Wow, he must feel really good about that. Yeah, it's a big accomplishment.
Yeah, he is feeling pretty good, but he's not looking at states right now. He's just going match by match. So hopefully that'll help him get to the state tournament.
That's a good mindset.
Good pass from Billy Brooks.
Silver Creek passing around. The score is 34 Warriors and 36 Silver Creek.
And good rebound by Matt.
See, Matt Crandall is not the tallest guy, but he's a good example at if you just box out, you can get the rebound. You know, you don't got to be tall to get every single rebound.
Good shot from Andy Crandall.
The score is now tied, and there's 5 minutes and 23 seconds in the third quarter. So let's see what Silver Creek is going to do this play. Hopefully Warriors can put a stop.
Good nice steal from Matt.
He's had a lot of steals tonight, actually. Warriors passing it around. Jared Fish up. And he makes it. I just feel like he needs to shoot a little bit more.
The Warriors playing a lot better offense in this half than the second and the first.
Silver Creek passing it around. And that was a questionable travel by the crowd. Number two, Frank Wolf, up with the three and just misses. Jared Fish with the rebound passes it to Tyler Stepierik, and Tyler Stepierik is driving and tries to kick it out and draws the foul.
Foul on number 44, Sherman Williams, and that's his third.
Also, tonight we have some competition right next to us. WGWE is here today. So maybe you're listening to that on 105.9. It's always nice to have them here and involve our school in community things. So they're always welcome here, and they're always nice to see. So Creek bringing the ball up, passing around, and up with the three, and misses. Andy Cranon with the rebound and pushing up the court. Questionable fouls there.
Three from Tad Beatty, but no good, but rebound. And put back by Jared Fish, and that's good.
Just a reminder, we're sponsored by Major Mountain Alpacas. So go down, get your alpaca socks, your ski hats, alpaca bears, alpaca blankets, sweaters, and rugs. So, Jaren, you have a pair of alpaca socks, don't you?
Yes, I do, and they're actually really warm. I wear them for hunting, but you can wear them for all sorts of stuff when you're outside in the cold.
Here to Marky.
I'm here with PE teacher Mr. Morton. And Mr. Morton, why are you out here at the basketball game tonight?
I came tonight because I want to watch two of the best teams in this area play tonight. And so far, the game has been outstanding. And we're up 40-36. And if we can keep this pace and beat them, last time we lost to them, hopefully tonight we can beat them. Because we'll maybe see them again down the road. You never know in the playoffs. But kids are looking great tonight. And I hope that we can hang on and pull out a win.
Thank you, Mr. Morton. Back to you, anchors.
Thank you, Marky. Didn't miss much. They just passed the ball in, and Silver Creek's passing it around. And it looks like King Kettle is back in the game. And a questionable foul on that. The Warriors crowd is not happy about that, but I mean, you can't argue with the refs whether you like the call or not. You know, Jaren?
Mm-hmm. I thought that was a bad call, actually. It should have been a jump ball.
And you used to play basketball, right?
Yes, but I did both all through high school. And now
wrestling and basketball?
Mm-hmm. Now I just decided to do one. It's easier.
And do you like that better? Do you miss it?
I do actually miss basketball a little bit, but wrestling is really fun. I like it.
And I just also want to point out that Billy Brooks is left-handed, which is a little bit harder to guard than right-handed players. So that's a little advantage for him, besides the advantage, obviously, that he's 6'7". The Warriors passing the ball around. Pass it to Andy Crandall.
Good putback by Matt Crandall.
Good teamwork by the brothers of the team. What do you think the coach said to Kane Kettle, Jaren?
Probably just play smart and
slide your feet and don't reach.
Yeah, don't reach. Just be smart on the court.
Yeah, besides skill, you also need the brains to play basketball. It's actually a really tough sport to learn. There's all these terms and all these rules. And there is a foul on Billy Brooks. The crowd is actually really happy and excited about that. He actually has three fouls, so hopefully they can push two more on him so he's out of the game.
The current score is 42-40, Warriors, with 2 minutes and 43 seconds left in the third quarter.
Another shout out to the Major Mountain Alpacas. Their store is called So Soft Gift Shop. How about you go check it out in Little Valley? Get yourself some things to stay warm, and we would also like to thank them for sponsoring us. First basket is made by Jared Fish. We would also like you to know that video earlier of the basketball team was made by Joe Hinman. So give him some credit.
Good free throw shooting by Jared Fish. Put the Warriors up by four.
Passing it to Billy Brooks, and he tries to go up and kicks it out. Nice rebound by Andy Crandall, pushing up the court, and he loses it. Nice defense by Matt Crandall. He's Billy Brooks is obviously a lot taller than him, but there's nothing you can do than to stand straight up and don't foul. Silver Creek's ball, about to pass it in. Kane Kettle is going to pass it into Sherman Williams. Matt Crandall is trying to cut off Billy Brooks so he doesn't post up, so that's a smart decision. 3 seconds has been called on Billy Brooks, which actually I'm surprised it hasn't been called more. You know, he just stands in there and it's not really fair, so I'm glad they see that now, and hopefully they look for it some more later on in the game.
Warriors passing the ball around. Looking for an opening. Good pass from Andy down low to Matt. And foul on number 45, Brennan White.
That actually was a really good call. I seen Matt Crandall jerk forward. And he was about to shoot that.
Matt Crandall will be passing the ball in. Passes it to Tyler Spierk, wide open for three. No good.
Warriors steal the ball from King Kettle.
And he pulls up for three, and no good.
And Tyler Spierk comes out of nowhere and tries to shoot over Billy Brooks, but
good rebound
doesn't really manage to.
And one.
And the crowd goes wild. Everybody is pumped up over here, including the players. So hopefully this is a motivator to the players to step their game up and let's just go get that win.
Keep playing smart. Keep the job.
The coach should be really proud of Jared Fish. Every time he gets a rebound, he puts it right back up. And he makes it. That's a timeout by Mr. K. Why do you think he called that timeout? They seem to be doing really good.
Just to get the players a break, I think.
Yeah, they've been working hard out there. Maybe they need a breather or need some water. It looks like he has his board out. And
wants
he's
to set something up on offense.
Yeah.
Get some offense rolling.
Now we're going to go to Marky Moore up in the stands.
I'm here with the Dean of Students, Mr. Long. Mr. Long, how do you think the Warriors are doing so far tonight?
I think they're doing very well. I'm proud of them. They came back from a pretty big deficit, and they now have the lead. On top of the team, I'm proud of the fans. It's good to see the student body out here cheering for their classmates.
Thank you, Mr. Long. All right, back to you, anchors.
Thank you, Marky. Haven't been missing much here, just the end of the timeout, and Silver Creek's about to pass right back in. The score is 47 Warriors and 42 Silver Creek, so hopefully the Warriors keep the lead in the third quarter and play a hard fourth quarter also to make sure they get the W.
Almost a steal by Matt Crandall.
Billy Brooks up and in. You know, we haven't seen as much as I thought we would see of Billy Brooks. You know, he's like the big talk, and we haven't really, the Warriors seem like they've shut him down pretty good.
Jared Fish has been doing a good job on defense against him.
So is Matt Crandall. I'm saying he's playing D9 defense, and there's not much you can do. The Silver Creek with the steal, and luckily he travels. So maybe the Warriors should watch their passes and not let them steal it. Warriors passing it around.
Looking.
Nice crossover by Damian, and he's up and in.
Good take by Damian Taylor there.
Like I said, Damian is a phenomenal player, and I was actually talking to him earlier, and he actually said that he wanted to go play in college. So he's excited about that. Billy Brooks driving in and kicks it to 45, which seems like their play. You know, Billy catches it on the foul line, and someone at the short corner cuts in. That seems to be working for them.
Foul by Matt Crandall. It'll be on the floor and not shooting. The Warriors are lucky by that because they would have given up an and one.
Luckily, that's Matt Crandall's first foul of the game, though. Damian Taylor driving up. And it looks like he's going to go all the way. And there is a foul, which is a very good call on the ref because it was so fast you didn't even notice it happened. So good thing he's seen that because that's just what the Warriors needed. And Joe Hinman's back in with the return. Warriors about to pass it in. Let's see if they can get an easy layup on this play.
That's Sherman Williams' fourth foul.
The Warriors seem like they're doing pretty good on driving to the basket and making them foul them, which is smart on their part.
They have been creating a lot of fouls tonight.
Pass in to Andy Crandall and passes it back. Damian with the three. And just misses.
Good bucket by Jared Fish right at the buzzer.
Those buzzer beaters are always very exciting. It gets you pumped for the next quarter coming up, which is the fourth.
The Warriors are playing very good this half, and they're up 51-44 here headed into the fourth quarter.
Hopefully they keep the lead if they want the W. Just want another shout out to the Major Mountain Alpaca store called So Soft Gift Shop in Little Valley. And here we are with Marky Moore.
I'm here with Pickles and Rachel, new sixth graders this year. How do you girls feel about being mixed in with all the big high school kids?
I really enjoy it because my brother and sister in the high school, and my sister always texts me asking for cookies.
How about you?
I like it because I can be with my sister.
Awesome. Thank you, girls. Back to you, anchors.
Thank you, Marky. Those girls are really cute, actually. Pickles. We actually know her. That's our teacher's daughter. And she's always full of energy and always has something funny to say. So she's really cute. So what about prom this year, guys?
I'm pretty excited.
Pretty
are
excited.
You excited, Lissa?
Yeah. What colors are you guys wearing? I think I'm going to go like a coral color.
I was thinking about a peach or a pink peach.
About you, Jaren, you're not sure yet. Are you bringing your girlfriend to prom? I know she's not from around here.
Maybe, I'm not sure yet.
Yeah, the juniors are actually running the prom, so hopefully they do a good job and raise enough money to have a nice prom.
I hear it's a masquerade this year.
Warriors passing it in. The cheerleaders are encouraging them and seem to help them out.
Damien's going to the line. Foul on Billy Brooks, and that's his fourth, so one more and he's done.
It's really exciting when it gets that close. With the fouls, it's exciting for the team, like the Warriors, to have Silver Creek have all these fouls to give them a big advantage.
They just want their best player to get out. First free throw was good by Damien. Shoots his second and good.
Just like I said earlier, a game like this, you want to make sure you make both your free throws. And I know Mr. K is really big on that. I always see them at the end of practice making free throws.
Good defense by Jared.
He tries to take a charge, but it just doesn't seem like it worked. Ted Beatty up and in. Ted Beatty isn't scared seeing how Billy Brooks is 6'7". It doesn't even faze him.
It's fearless.
They're all passing around Silver Creek. And the three is good, which they should get out on that. A close game like this, you don't want them to make a three. Warriors passing around, and Damien goes up with the shot. And good. You know, sometimes it doesn't even look like he's set. You know, like he has good position with his feet and everything. He just throws it right up there and it goes in. He's just that good, I guess, huh, Jaren?
Very good ball handler, shooter. Pretty good on defense.
He's good at everything. You know, he can post up. He can be a guard. It doesn't really matter where he is. He knows what he's doing. Billy Brooks tries to go up. And makes it. There's nothing you can really do about that except put your hand straight up and hope for the best. Warriors passing around. Let's see if Joe Hinman gets a big play here. Damien with the deep three and Tad with the rebound.
Good rebound by Tad.
Damien Taylor with a really good catch.
No good by Tad Beatty.
Silver Creek with their same play like they always do. Billy Brooks in. Score is now 57-51. It's getting closer, so let's see if the Warriors can get a stop.
Billy's pretty effective this quarter.
Joe Henry. You know, that's his strength right there. You can't leave him open, especially on the side of the basket, too. That's where he always makes it.
And there's your big play.
There it is. You can always count on Joe. Kane Kettle up with a three and in. That was actually a deep three, too, so we can't leave him open.
Gives it right back to the Warriors.
Seems like the Warriors are going back and forth. Let's see if we can get another three on this play right here. Warriors passing around. They have 20 seconds on the shot clock. Passing back to Damien, and he drives. And I seen that too. Number 44 is getting a little close.
That is his fifth foul. And
the Warriors
done.
Did it. So Mr. K should be really proud of them for accomplishing another one of their goals. And number 44, Sherman Williams, is actually a big part of their team, so.
Good ball handler.
Hopefully the Warriors can pull through this and keep the lead and get the win. Let's see if Damien will make his foul shots, and I'm sure he will. I just want to point out that this is Brian Kosoniak's sixth year of coaching, and it seems like the Warriors have actually done pretty good with him coaching. He seems like he knows what he's doing, and he pushes them to where he knows they can go.
He's learned from one of the best coaches from the school, Mr. Weishan, which is your coach now, Alyssa.
Yes, actually, he's a really good coach. He knows what he's talking about. This is either his 39th or 40th year coaching, so we're actually really lucky to still have him. He loves the game, and he knows a lot about it. Warriors passing around.
Good defense. But Billy does make it, so.
Billy with his good post moves and fakes. Warriors are passing around. Jared Fish up and in. That looks like a questionable foul right there. Looks like Billy smacked his arm a little bit, but the refs didn't call anything.
Good move by Jared, though.
Good pressure from the Warriors. You need to get right up on them, even if they are deep in the three-point. 14 up at the three and in. I've noticed he's hit a lot of shots, Connor Gates, so can't leave him open.
A couple three-pointers this half.
Warriors passing around, giving the ball to Damian. And he drives with some nice moves and in. The X factor is back, and he means business. Oh, Damian with almost a steal. And Kane Kettle with the and one. You know, we can't have that happen. Just want to point out that Matt Crandall and Joe Himmon, both seniors, are captains, and they seem to be leading this team very well, setting a good example for the underclassmen. So hopefully the future of the boys varsity basketball here, it turns out really good.
Good defense by Jared Fish, and it'll be Warriors ball.
And Tyler Siperic is in for Joe. Joe play hard, and he deserves a little break.
Had a nice three-pointer over there in the corner.
Tyler Siperic hopefully helps out the Warriors in this time of need to keep the lead.
Clear out, guys.
Damian Taylor with some excellent ball handling. Jared Fish. And they call it a jump ball, which everyone's questioning a travel or a foul, and nobody really knows, but the ref's call is final.
The Warriors are up 66-61, about 3 minutes left.
Hands up, Bill.
Silver Creek passing around. They seem to be always good with that.
Good and bucket Kane by Kettle. Kane Kettle.
I think the Warriors need to be reminded of their goals, and hopefully they can execute those. Damian Taylor in the big finish, and the crowd is crazy over here.
Good take by Damian Taylor.
He's like really determined. He gets the ball, and the first thing he does is look to attack, so that's always good. Can't leave Kane Kettle open. Just misses it. Jared with a big rebound and a questionable foul there again.
It'll stay Warriors ball and Coach K calls a timeout.
I feel like he's reminding them of their goals to box out and shot fake and look to attack. So let's go over to Marky Moore. All right, and we're having a little bit of technical difficulties, so let's see if we can get those figured out. Just want to go back to the score. It's 68 Warriors and 63 Silver Creek with 2 minutes left in the fourth. So hopefully the Warriors will keep the lead and they'll come up with this W. Their goals look pretty good. So hopefully they execute those.
The Warriors are back out here on the court. With about 2 minutes and 11 seconds left in the game, and they're up 5.
I always feel like Salamanca has a really good crowd. You know, they're very supportive and...
Foul on number 14, Connor Gates.
Some students over there are chanting Warrior Nation. So hopefully that gets into the player's head and gets them determined to get this win. Tyler Siparek is pretty good from the foul line, so hopefully he makes these. It can make a big difference in the game.
Looks like the student section is getting into it.
And the student section over there is actually really big. All the bleachers are filled everywhere you look around the gym, so that's always nice to see that everybody's so involved and
comes out and supports our Warriors.
And it's good. Another shout out to the Major Mountain Alpaca store called SoSoft Gift Shop. Go check it out in Little Valley.
Good job by Tyler for making both of his free throws. All the way to do is play good defense.
That was a questionable foul. Not really sure who that is on right now. But Frank Wolf does a good job drawing it.
And that was Jared's third foul. With about 2 minutes left here in the game.
The Warriors need to get a little bit of a run and maybe even run off the shot clock. And the clock, so.
Missed free throw by Frankie Wolf.
Frankie Wolf is actually only in 10th grade, so that's actually really impressive to see him on the varsity team. He must be a hard worker. And it looks like he's one of the first off the bench.
Foul on number 14, Connor Gates.
Silver Creek seems to be putting the pressure on the Warriors, but it doesn't seem to be working.
And that is his fourth foul. All the Knights players in better be careful, or the bench players that haven't been playing tonight are going to have to step up and come in the game.
They probably the wrong guy, though. Yeah, he can shoot.
And he misses. He's a little upset about that, but he needs to practice more, bend his knees a little bit. And it's good.
Warriors need to step up the defense here late in the game.
And not foul either. And everybody's getting on the ground.
Good hustle by both teams.
And it looks like Andy Crandall is hurt. I know that he did sprain his ankle earlier and couldn't play this football season. Is that correct, Sharon?
He actually broke his ankle this football season.
And the Knights pass it in. We don't want to foul them because it's such a close game.
Don't want to give them easy buckets.
And Silver Creek calls a timeout.
The current score is 71 Warriors and 65 Silver Creek with 1 minute and 24 seconds left in the fourth quarter.
Just a shout out to WGWE on 105.9. They always have good music on there and some good jokes, and so hopefully you go check that out.
They're always out and about around the area doing basketball games, girls and guys. And they'll also do some football games in the fall.
So it's always nice to see them around. Another shout out to our sponsor, and a big thank you to Major Mountain Alpaca, and their store is called So Soft Gift Shop in Little Valley.
They sell alpaca socks, ski hats, alpaca bears, blankets, sweaters, and rugs. So go down to their shop and get things you need for the winter.
Seems like they have a lot of things there. It's not just clothes, it's rugs. And I guess they do have Valentine's Day presents too, so go get some stuff for your honey. Go check it out in Little Valley.
Silver Creek's looking to press.
Let's see if the Warriors can break the press. Yep, Damian Taylor pushing the court up.
Gets blocked by Billy Brooks, but it goes out of bounds, and the Warriors will contain possession.
Tyler's the parrot, gets the ball, passes it to Andy Crandall, and they foul. They want to foul because they want to stop the clock, but I don't really know if it's a good decision right now because it's 1-1 and he's shooting, so hopefully he makes these and gets a bigger lead. So, Jaron, tell us more about the wrestling and remind us when and where it is.
It is here on Friday and Saturday. And wrestling on Friday will start about 5 o'clock, and wrestling on Saturday will start at 9.
How many teams do you have coming?
I think there's around 15.
It's a lot of teams, so it should be good. So come down and check that out.
A lot of good competition.
Good job, Nick.
A lot of teams from PA, and Pennsylvania is really good at wrestling.
That'll be different because I'm not sure if we've ever had teams from Pennsylvania come down here. But it should be exciting, so come down and check that out.
Made free throw by Andy Crandall.
Knights are looking for Billy Brooks and pass it up to Kane Kettle. Those are both the go-to guys, I feel like.
Look up!
And Tyler Sparrow gets fouled hard by Silver Creek. I know they want to stop the clock, but not really sure if intentionally pushing down like that is very necessary. So Tyler Sparrow hopefully make his foul shots. The score is 72 Warriors and 63 Silver Creek with 59 seconds left in the fourth quarter. But 59 seconds can extend into a long time with all the timeouts and fouls and everything, so this could be anybody's game still.
Made free throw by Tyler. Shooting a second. And it is no good.
Defense, play deep!
Hopefully they can play some good defense without fouling.
Good move,
and the Knights coach is a little excited and he wants them to press.
Foul by Frank Wolf on Jared Fish, and he'll be going to the line to shoot two.
I'm pretty confident that he'll make them.
That's only Frank Wolf's second foul.
I just also want to point out that the Warriors did get new uniforms this year, is that correct?
Mm-hmm. They went from Adidas to Under Armour. So
that's a big change. Big change in the feeling and in the looks. They actually look really good out there.
Yep, look a little better than last year.
And I noticed they all have pretty cool shoes, too. I mean, last game they did, too. But both teams had pretty cool shoes.
Warriors need to play defense.
And 14 up with the three and no good.
Good foul. Good rebound by Tyler Zaparek.
And that is a timeout by Mr. K. So hopefully from his 6 years of coaching the Salamanca Warriors, he knows what he's doing. Just want to thank everybody for let this game happen, like the refs and the crowd and the players and our superintendent, Mr. Robert Bridenstine, principal, Mrs. Anne Marie Anderson, athletic director, Mr. Christopher Siebert, and assistant AD, Mr. Rich Morton. So without them, we would not have a basketball game right now. So big thank you to them. They do a lot for our school.
And I want to say thank you to Ms. Hill and Mr. Major for helping us broadcast tonight.
Yeah, we are actually the only school in this area that does this, like broadcast sports events and plays and kindergarten recognition. And we do everything, and we sell CDs, and it goes into our account so we can buy shirts.
And new equipment.
And new equipment for our members. It's actually nice to see our media class here is actually growing, and we're getting new high-tech things. So it's exciting to see what the future holds for that class.
And I'm sure it's a different thing for other schools, too, to see.
Yeah, I'm sure they've never seen it before like we do. And Silver Creek fouls again, Tyler Sakarik. So hopefully he makes these. There's only 30 seconds left, and the Warriors are up 74-69. It's not a big lead, so hopefully they can keep it together, keep good passes, and no stupid fouls.
Yep, Tyler needs to make these. Kudo. So it's not that close. He makes his first.
The Warriors seem like they have pretty good teamwork out there, and they like playing with each other. They always encourage each other and are happy to be playing for the Salamanca Warriors.
This free throw by Brennan White, and Damian's wide open.
And he dunks it. The X Factor drives the crowd crazy out here. You know, gets everybody so pumped to see that.
I think that did it for the Warriors. About 5 seconds left.
And a foul at 3.7 seconds.
And Kane Kettle fouls out.
Yo, Damien's a little show-off there.
That was a pretty hard dunk by Damien there.
Good thing he didn't miss, because that would be pretty embarrassing. But, you know, he never really misses, no matter where he is or what he's doing. And, I mean, if I could dunk, I'd be showing off, too. So you can't really complain about that.
And tonight, Damien is the lead scorer for the team.
Oh, the students over there are standing up, and looks like they're ready to cheer.
Pretty excited after Damien's dunk.
Yeah, the crowd is fired up.
Good free throw by Tyler.
The Warriors pull this off. This is a big win over Silver Creek, so the other teams better watch out for the Warriors because we're coming in hot.
Huge league win for the Warriors. And good game, and congratulations to the Warriors.
The final score is 80-71, Warriors.
And that's the game. The final score is 80 Warriors and 71 Silver Creek, making the Salamanca Warriors 8-3. Both teams played their hearts out and gave us an exciting game. Good luck to the to Salamanca's other sports that are playing this week. This has been a Warrior Vision production. Thanks for watching, and we hope you tune in next time.